Hazel, good afternoon to you.
Oh, good afternoon, Geoffrey, and good afternoon, Premier. My husband, Joseph, and I have lived in West Australia a lot of years, and what we're concerned about is the fact that we're hearing that you might be thinking about selling off Landgate to a private enterprise, and that troubles us immensely because it's a government instrumentality. But how can you guarantee that that's not going to cost the WA consumers a lot of money in the long run, and also about the safety of the material that they would inherit if they took over the Landgate?
Hazel, thank you.
Thanks so much, Hazel, and best wishes to you and Joseph. We haven't made any decisions in that regard. South Australia and New South Wales have both commercialised their equivalents of Landgate with a range of protections around it for privacy and the like. If you went to Landgate today and did a search of my name, you'll find the house that I live in, you'll find how much I paid for the land, you'll find a lot of details of who was on the title document. You can do that for anyone in Western Australia currently. So there's a lot of information already out there, but the government hasn't made any decisions, Hazel. But if we did, the privacy and the protections that are currently there, of course, we would insist upon the highest standards.
So we got an email today. We heard there was a unanimous resolution passed at the WA Labor State Executive meeting on Monday night, quote, "We call for the WA Labor Party to retain ownership of Landgate in public hands. The party must not sell or lease our public property data. This motion builds on Labor's strong history of opposing privatisation." The question here was, will Mr. McGowan listen to the party and publicly commit to not privatising Landgate?
Well, obviously, we're always listening to the party, but we are the government and we'll take into account all those things and the interests of Western Australia in the decisions that we make. The state is in a difficult financial situation because we inherited $40 billion of Liberal national debt. So we have to deal with that as well and also provide good services and make sure we attract jobs to Western Australia. All those things we are balancing at this given point in time, and we'll always make decisions in the public interest.